Hey, I'm Lisa.
And I'm Lucy.
And we're two sisters who have been running a sticker shop for over 7 years.
Get ready to ignite your entrepreneurial spirit with our small business podcast. Join us as we explore the exciting world of entrepreneurship and stickers.
Tune in for inspiration, tips, and expert insights that will help you turn your big plans into a thriving business. Now, let's get started. And we are back with another episode. And today is actually a very controversial topic. It is a hot, hot, hot topic about AI art. So we actually weren't planning on doing this episode, but it recently came to our attention that this has been kind of a trending hot topic within the planner community lately. So we're like, oh, you know, let's do an episode on this because I feel like it's new, it's interesting. There's definitely lots of opinions with it. So in this episode, we're going to be talking about, I guess, our take on AI art.
Yeah, we'll be discussing the question about, you know, what are the arguments for and against AI art? Is the shop owner responsible for disclosing that they're using AI art? As well as, like, what do we think about AI art? Mm-hmm. And I was reminded that I listened to a podcast and I can't remember whose, so I apologize, but I listened to someone else's planner podcast, I think earlier this year or last year, where they did predictions on the planner community. They predicted like, oh, we're going to be seeing a lot more AI art. And at the time when I heard that, I was like, okay, like I didn't think much about it, but it really is like a thing that has infiltrated the planner community quite a bit. Mm-hmm. And so let's talk about it.
Yeah. I just want to say, I don't know if I didn't hear it from a podcast, but I saw someone's TikTok that it was like their bingo card for the predictions for this year. And like they predicted on their like bingo card that there would be an AI art scandal. And I feel like this is not necessarily a scandal, but definitely some controversy surrounding AI art.
Yes.
So go ahead and talk about maybe some of the arguments for AI art. So maybe some pros to it.
As well, let's do pros and cons. Let's mix it up because
okay, yeah, let's alternate.
I think ultimately, if you're interested about our take, we're not 100% yes. We're not 100% no. You know, it's, I feel like it's, I understand both sides. Like I totally get it. I haven't made up my mind on where we're at personally, also because we use things like ChatGPT in our business and I love ChatGPT. Okay. Y'all, we pay for ChatGPT.
Yeah.
Like $20 a month.
We have a subscription with ChatGPT and it has been really helpful to say the least.
Yeah. Someone asked us, because I think we mentioned it in our reels. Yeah. And someone was asking, like, what do we use it for? Things like creating a listing description. Like, that was so painful for me to, like, have to write out a boring listing description. Like, that writes it out for us. Like, our podcasts. I can take our entire transcript of a podcast episode, put it into ChatGPT. It will spit out, like, the show notes, our blog post, et cetera. So it's just been so helpful. And my husband hates AI, but I love it.
Really?
He hates it.
Oh, no. Well, he hates Apple. Like, we always clown him because he has an Android. And so, he's not in the family group chat.
He is on his iPad. But yes, like, it's definitely like, I understand why people don't like AI. But we over here at Sticker Guru, we love ChatGPT.
Yes.
It's my bestie.
It's our assistant.
Yep.
And we pay it $20 a month.
You do pay that $20. It's so worth it. If y'all are thinking about ChatGPT, I highly recommend at least trying it out because there are so many applications to using it.
Mm-hmm.
So let's go into the pros of AI art. First off, I'm just going to say it is more efficient and faster. Like in terms of how I imagine, I'm guessing because like, for example, when I use ChatGPT, I could spend like an hour trying to write out a listing description or it can spit out one out for me in like 5 seconds. So it's kind of like a no-brainer in terms of like, mm-hmm. it's a lot more efficient, faster to use AI for these things that you may struggle with.
Yeah. Plus, we have commissioned art quite a bit in the past with like several different artists. And, you know, that can take anywhere from a week to up to a month.
Over a month.
Yeah. So that definitely is time consuming. And like when you're running a business, you have to think about these things well far in advance. So if you have to plan out a specific release, you better have that art commissioned and ready to go like a month early. So that definitely is one aspect of why I think AI is winning in that department, is that it's just so much faster.
Definitely. Like thinking about artists, just like when we purchase art from artists on Etsy or Creative Market, sometimes I need to make a design for, let's say, Christmas, but I need to design this Christmas thing in like July. But there's no new art out for Christmas in July.
And we're like selling this by August.
Yeah.
Because if we were to sell it any later, it would be too late. Like everyone would already have their Christmas stuff purchased already. They wouldn't be buying Christmas stuff in November and December because it's already too late.
Yeah. And it always makes me sad when I see artists put out something really, really cute for a seasonal thing. And I'm like, shoot, like they put out something really cute for Christmas, but Christmas is in 2 weeks. It's like, I really wish I could use this art, but there's no way that I can because it's too late. Like, I'd have to wait till next year, basically.
Yeah. And like, the reason is that because like, people aren't going to buy the Christmas kits 2 weeks before Christmas.
Like, we're planners. You got to plan ahead. So
exactly. So that's why we release things super early. And that's why like, a lot of the community releases seasonal stuff months in advance.
Exactly. So in terms of that, like I understand why AI art is so attractive because there's, you know, it is out there so much quicker.
Yeah. It's readily available.
Yes, readily available. So let's talk about a con for AI art. And I think this is the biggest one that people might argue for is that you're putting artists out of business. What are your thoughts?
I mean, that is definitely valid.
Yeah. Just like the amount of art available, like if going back to our example of like having the Christmas art like ready in July, then I'm not going to be spending my money elsewhere, right? Like I'm not going to be buying that artist who is putting out their art later because I need it now. And so therefore, they're not going to get my business.
They are missing out on a sale.
I do think that artists could think about the cycle a bit more about like, okay, well, I need to like plan in advance. If you are an artist who is selling to sticker shops, primarily like thinking more about like, okay, what are the planner shops cycles and how do I follow that? Because I do feel like a lot of times the art just comes out too late.
Yeah, that's true. I feel like if they did release things earlier, then I would be more willing to buy their art because it's, you know, it is ready. Instead of it being, you know, released too late. And by that point, I'm like, okay, I don't want to buy their art because it's too late.
Yeah. Like, I would prefer to buy from an artist, but it really is like a timing thing for us, at least, in terms of like, I got to have this art now because I have to put something out.
Plus, so I feel like there's just like, we've used so much of the art that's out there already. So like, we want new art. And
yes.
That's just like, it's hard to come by, especially when you've been around for so long. So you just want like new art, but the new art is always late. So then it's like, well, here's where AI comes in.
Yeah. Another thing about AI art, and maybe that's like goes into this, is like there's just so much more variety of art. Like, I feel like Etsy is being flooded by AI art right now. Like, there's so much
art. Like,
it's kind of crazy.
It's a little overwhelming, to be honest. And a lot of it looks so similar that I'm just like, dude, this is like the same thing over and over again. But like, there's just so much of it. And like, there really is a lot to choose from. Yeah.
Yeah. As someone who like, I'm thinking about more specific holidays, like, for example, Lunar New Year. We had our own art commissioned because for Lunar New Year, there was like no art for a very long time.
Yeah. Or there was only like one option. Like,
and
and everyone
use that option
already.
Slash, or like it's an option that's not really our style, doesn't fit our shop. But yeah, there's just so much more variety now that there's a lot more to choose from. And that's really helpful to a sticker shop owner who we've been around for 7 years. Like we've released and used so much art from artists that there's not a ton out there that we haven't purchased already.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So the AI is good for creating new art for us.
Yeah. And also like I like to personally reformat our kits because it's a lot easier on us. Mm-hmm. But I feel like our customers are always looking for new stuff, which is understandable. If they've already bought your kit, they're not going to buy it again. But
mm-hmm.
like, I feel like they're also always looking for new, new. And so then
it forces us to do new.
Yeah, because if I could, I would just reformat everything.
Yeah,
like, I would love to do that.
Yeah, I would love to just reuse the art over and over again. But our customers, like, they get sick of it. So they don't buy it. And then they're not buying. I'm like, well, why am I making this?
Yeah. Yeah. So I do understand why people do want just, you know, the variety of art. And that is something that AI art has been providing.
Mm-hmm.
Especially if you go on Etsy right now. It's insane how much art is flooding Etsy.
Yeah. Okay. So let's talk about another con. So I would say something that we've experienced trying to generate AI art is that you really have to be specific about your description. And if you're not specific enough, some of the things that will generate are just like really strange and like lacks context. Like, for example, I think we tried generating something that was like a picnic. And the things that it generated was like very, I don't know how to describe it other than that it was very freaky.
Like a nightmare. Like, literally, like when you think of a dream, you know, like how things are never like really clear and they're kind of like
a little, something's off about
something's
it.
Off. Like it's like that. It's nightmarish.
Yeah. It's like freakish. And if you look a little too closely, you're like, what is this? Like it's not real food. Like
I remember like trying to make a pizza. I still have not gotten the ability. Like I've tried to generate pizza so many times. I've not been able to get it right. But pizza, like it turns out so scary because I don't think it understands like toppings, you know, like I don't know what it is, but like pizza comes out really, really scary because you're like, what the hell is this on the pizza?
The way I know exactly what, like what I can imagine, like how freakish it looks and just like, what the heck is this? So So AI is definitely not perfect by any means. And you're going to be generating like some weird stuff.
Yes. And for that reason, I feel like artists are superior in that sense of like, you can tell them what you want and they have a brain.
Yeah.
You know, like they can.
I'm going to draw something freakish like that. Like, you know how to draw a pizza.
You can also give them feedback like, hey, I just want this dress in a like slightly shorter or in a different color. And then they can change that for you. Whereas I think with AI, it's not going to generate the exact same thing for you, but with that slight change.
Yeah.
At least from my understanding. So in that sense, like artists are really
are superior. Better for that. Better for detail, in my opinion.
Like the stuff of nightmares. It's so scary, guys. If you are on our texting, I don't know what to call our texting list. I sent out this thing the other day for 2 Hour Tuesday, and I tried using AI because there's a new AI feature for our texting, and I had it take a photo of Lisa holding our.
Oh, it was the Ocean $2 Tuesday.
Yes,
and you like AI generated the background into like a ocean.
I was like, have it look like it's in the ocean, and it was kind of like, it wasn't, it's clearly fake. First
yeah.
of all.
Like
clearly
it's fake. Giving Zoom background. You're in the, and your background is like, you're in the ocean.
Like
it's
green like screen.
That. Yeah. Like green effect. Screen effect. Like,
but, and if you look too closely, you're like, ew, what is this?
I saw that and I was like, whoa, what is this? I was like, this is some like AI fill green screen thing. Like
it was something fun to like. It gave you three options, and that was the best one, okay?
I
there
see.
Were some other scarier one, but it's certainly not perfect, but it was just fun. Like, I think AI can be I personally love experimenting with AI, but again,
it's definitely not perfect.
It's not perfect
by any means.
Yes.
But it's like cool to see what it'll come up with, you know?
And everything's incorporating AI nowadays. And I'm just like, I'll try it. Like, why not?
Dude, have you seen those TikToks where it's like Snapchat, or they're like Snapchat's AI and they're like chatting it?
Oh, yes. Yes. I love those.
Chat GPT, and they'll say like really, they'll like literally say such bizarre things.
Like, oh, I've abducted this plane and yeah, now we're taking
and
off.
Now we're taking it. Even though like it's completely fake and they're just like saying fun things to the AI just to see what the AI will say. And the AI is always like they always give like a pleasant response, like, oh no, that is not safe to do. Please
wait for the authorities.
Yeah, please wait for the authorities. Please do not take off on this plane. It's just the funniest thing ever.
I don't know. Like, I love it. I feel like it's just a very fun time at this point in human history where we are just starting with AI. And I like to see what comes from it.
Yeah, it's very interesting.
Yeah. So one pro for AI art that I can see from the shop owner perspective is that it is cost effective. But I am going to argue that maybe it's not so cost effective as people think.
Yeah.
So
I would say cost effective in the sense that like you're generating what is essentially exclusive art, which is typically when you commission art that is exclusive, it's pretty expensive from our experience of commissioning art that's
like
exclusive to our shop.
Could be hundreds.
Could be like even thousands.
Yeah.
So like that's quite expensive when you're just selling stickers. So I can see why like shops like using AI to create exclusive art, because it's a lot cheaper than commissioning art. With that being said, it's not necessarily the most cost effective because like you have to like pay for it.
Yes. Yeah, so in terms of like AI stuff, like at least from what I've done in my research, like you have to pay to use these things, and like you're paying a monthly subscription. Like, for example, we pay $20 a month for ChatGPT. So like you are paying a membership. This isn't for free.
Mm-hmm.
That being said, is it cheaper than us when we pay an artist like hundreds of dollars for an exclusive art? Yes, it is. I would say ultimately, yes, it is cheaper, but is it cheaper than us like buying, let's say, clip art from a shop? Maybe not. But also I can see how like all the new AI art that's flooding into Etsy right now, it's so cheap. Like you can buy like a clip art set for like $1, you know, $3 versus like buying art from a planner art shop where like the art is meant for sticker shops to use for their planner stickers, that might be like $20.
So, I see.
Yeah. In that sense, yes, it is cheaper.
I see. Yeah. That does make sense from a business standpoint that like you are saving yourself, I don't know, like at least $10 per kit that you're creating. Yeah. I could see why shop owners would prefer to spend just a couple dollars on some AI art versus spending, you know, $20 plus on a whole collection of art.
Yeah.
Okay. Before we jump into our last argument against AI art, let's go ahead and take a break. Ready to create stunning stickers in no time? Introducing Creating Stickers Made Easy, the comprehensive e-course that makes designing and cutting planner stickers a breeze.
Join us, Lisa and Lucy, two seasoned sticker shop owners, and master silhouette studio with step-by-step instructions, templates, and troubleshooting tips.
Why struggle alone when you can learn from the pros?
Sign up today at bigplansacademy.com and unleash your creativity.
And now we're back. So the last thing is like this whole moral gray area. Like, is this ethical? Is this unethical? Is this legal? Is it illegal? It's like
hard
kind
to
of
say.
And yeah. I'm not a lawyer. I don't you know, like I'm not familiar with like copyright, trademark, fair use, etc. So I'm not the one who's going to say like, is this legal or not? From what I've seen in my research, like reading about the arguments for and against AI, it seems like technically, yes, this isn't illegal, at least right now, as of right now with the current laws, because of like fair use and things like that. Mm-hmm. But again,
unknown, like if that'll change in the future. And
yeah, that can easily change in the future.
And like how they'll enforce that, hard to say right now.
Yes. But in terms of like, is this ethical? Is it unethical? I'm just going to say it's in a gray area. Like it's a little dubious.
Yeah.
And I think that ultimately it's up to you as a sticker shop, you as a consumer, you as a human being using AI or not using it. Like it's up to you. You could very well be like us. We use ChatGPT. We love it. Or you can be like my husband who hates AI and wants nothing to do with it at all. So it's ultimately like a person by person thing. Mm-hmm. And I don't know if it's right for me to be like
to
I
say
personally
like
would not
right
impress my opinions on other people.
Yeah.
But
just because like there is no right or wrong answer in my opinion currently. So I guess that goes back to the question like, is a sticker shop owner responsible for disclosing that they're using AI art? And I have heard the argument that like shop owners who purchase art, they weren't aware that it's AI generated. Mm-hmm. Or like they don't know because if they bought it off of Etsy, like the person selling it on Etsy might not have disclosed that it's AI art, which again, I don't know if the person selling it has to disclose it, but it just kind of like is that question, like, are they responsible? Like, do they have to say that it's AI art?
I don't know. Like at this topic, like really, we aren't saying we're for one or for the mm-hmm. other.
Yeah, because there's definitely, you know, arguments for and against it. So I'm just curious, like, these are our thoughts on AI art. What kind of thoughts do you have about AI art? We would love to hear it. And yeah, this is definitely an ongoing discussion.
Yep, ongoing discussion. And I think what things will become a lot more clearer in the future as AI becomes more, you know, like in terms of like the law, things
like
become more clear.
Regulated.
Regulation, things like that. I think we'll have a clear answer then. But right now it kind of feels like the wild, wild west where everyone's trying to incorporate AI into their products because that's what they think the consumer wants. And I'm just here for the ride, here to test it all out.
Yeah, just here to experiment with what's available and what's out there.
One last thing, for those who are wondering, okay, well, like, how can I tell that something is generated by AI? I'm going to say there's no set way. Like, I don't think there's like a, oh, if you see this, you'll know for sure. But I'm going to say, just from my own experience, you can tell something is AI because it's not quite right. There's like kind of like a nightmarish quality to it is how I'd like to describe it.
It's a little funky looking when you look like up
when you
close.
Look something's
closely.
Not quite right.
Yeah. Something is amiss.
Because ultimately that's what makes, or not ultimately, but one of the things that makes an artist so amazing is that like they can discern like what is supposed to, how things are supposed to look. Whereas mm-hmm. AI is not a human being. It can't make those kind of things.
Yeah.
So for example, when you look at windows, when you look at like bicycle wheels, hands, my God, hands. Like they look really scary in AI. The pizza.
It can't generate it properly because it doesn't know like what's real.
Yeah, it doesn't have the kind of discernment that a human brain has. So ultimately, again, it's up to you on like, do you want this or not? But like sometimes you can just tell when you look at AI, like
mm-hmm.
this is not quite right. And do you care enough as a consumer, as a sticker shop owner to not use it or to use it? Like, I don't know. It's up to you.
Yeah, up to you. At the end of the day.
That's how I can tell when something is AI generated. Mm-hmm. It'll just be kind of
something
funky
is a little off about it.
Something is not quite right.
Thank you for listening. If you found this episode helpful, let us know by tagging us on Instagram at StickerGuru. Check out our show notes for everything we mentioned in this episode.
And if you haven't already, hit the follow button and leave a 5-star review to help us keep the good content flowing. Thank you so much for all of your support. We'll talk to you in the next one. Bye.
Bye.